Hey everybody, Fox Rose here, and we are back to Digimon Story Cyber Sleuth, and in this episode, we have to decide between going to visit Nokia in Kowloon, or going to see Arata-Senpai. So, obviously, we're gonna go see Arata-Senpai. People can make fun of me all they want, I don't care. I love Arata to death, he's a great character throughout the entire game. People can give me shit all they want. I'm being dead serious about that, actually. Okay, pretty sure we were supposed to meet in Shinjuku. Now, if you're curious, like, why I'm like, okay, is this where you're supposed to go? It's because I haven't played this game in a while. Kind of just been dealing with a lot of stuff IRL lately. But, yeah, other than that, I've just kind of been not thinking about this sort of thing, I guess. Even though gaming is my life. Oh, lordy. Ah, there's Arata-Senpai.
Yo,
hey, you're late. Well, I knew you'd be here. By the way, is Nokia okay? Yeah, she's fine. Don't worry about her. Whatever. You should learn to mind your own business. Well, excuse me, dude. When all said and done, people with a half-baked sense of justice and a superficial sense of responsibility are the worst. And for her to take trying to be a leader, she knows nothing about bearing responsibility. What are you getting into, man? But never mind that for now. I wanted to talk to you about that Sueto guy. Fuck you, Sueto! Okay, so I know the actual pronunciation is Sueto, but I read it like suede, so I keep saying Sueto, if anyone is curious. You remember him, right? Strange Kamishiro researcher who was studying mysterious phenomena. There was something he said that's been bothering me. Actually, I retraced our steps and saw him again the other day. Oh, you did now? What did you see, buddy? It really isn't very polite to follow someone, you know. I suppose this is payback for the other day. Arata-sanada. You caught me. Is there something I can do for you? Yes, you said something before that bothers me. I wanted to know more about your investigations, too. You think I can take a peek? Why? Attitude is so splendidly cynical. And you harbor such an interest in my work, too. I want you to tell me everything you know about Eden syndrome. I will, of course, share whatever I know. It must have been fate that brought us together here. If, before logging out from Eden, your mental data is destroyed by an eater, Eden's ability will wake up again. I see. So that's the reason behind this bizarre sickness?
Indeed. Although that is still just a hypothesis.
To think that logging into Eden could have an impact on the physical body in the real world. Don't you find that fascinating? And how is this syndrome cured? That's unfortunately, I do not know. Yet. I do have something interesting on shifts, though. Don't keep me hanging here. We've identified a pattern in digital wave abnormalities that trigger the digital shifts. There's always a certain amount of external interference immediately prior to digital shift. After that, the digital wave increases in bandwidth and the digital shift happens. Interference? Yes, which means someone or something is controlling these digital shifts. Gee, I wonder, could it be Kamishiro? That's one conclusion we can reach. Well, that's also nothing more than conjecture, actually. Someone's intentionally causing digital shifts. If you're interested, why not do some more research and study into what exactly is controlling the digital shifts? But I have to ask, why are you so interested in the Eater's and Eden syndrome?
good question. I really want to know what the cause of this bizarre illness is. I wonder if there are any clues around there. I want to try and search the area. And for you, the ship has already set sail, no? Come on, give me a hand. Anything for Arata-Senpai! Shut up, I love this shit. Because we gotta. Okay, let's go. Okay. See what we got here. A friend asked what I'd do if I became a human, but nothing comes to mind. You haven't been around humans all that long. Let's hang out and talk more. Ormon in the farm is max level, and Toyogamon in the farm is max level. Sounds like Sakura's still resting at home. I hope she feels better soon. That seems pretty random. It's boring when Sakura's not around. That seems pretty random. Especially for, you know, the conversation Arata and I were just having. Or rather, him talking at me, not really having a conversation. Oh, lovely. Here we go. Well, Arata-senpai, I have a confession to make. What's wrong? Why the sudden investigation of an Eden spot? What? You detected a special network? Apart from the connections to Eden? Hey, hold up. What are you talking about? See ya. Huh? Gone without a trace. Whoa. What in the heck is going on? Where in the heck? Yeah, I kinda just scared Arata. Oh well. Where am I? This is no ordinary network. It's much, much bigger, more expansive. Are these rapids in the digital wave? Only one way to find out, my friend. Which... can I force encounters? No, fuck. Well, there's nothing special in the tunnel if anyone's trying to do, like, a whole, like, completion run. From my memory, there's nothing special within this digital wave or labyrinth or whatever you want to call it. So, feel free to just blast on by. Like, no joke, just blast on by and you'll be fine. And lastly, on Metal Greymon, how about a Volcanic Palm? Bitch! Volcanapum. Oof, excuse me. Okay. Flying around at the speed of sound. I am so tired right now. As Jacksepticeye likes to say, sleep is for the weak. And if anyone's curious, that's kind of the motto I live by. I hate sleeping. I honest to God do hate sleeping. Well, yeah, sleeping is a good thing and helps you recharge your battery, so to speak. It takes up so much time that could be used for working. I'm not a workaholic, hell no. I'm far from a workaholic. But to me, sleep is just an inconvenience. If I could go 24/7 all year without sleep, I think I'd be a lot more fit, I'd get more videos out perfectly, I'd do a lot more work around the house. I just hate sleep. And why is that? Because I'm a morning person. And if you ask me, technically, 3 onward is like morning to me. Until it's, you know, the afternoon or the evening or shit like that. Nothing around. Oh, incoming call. Aha! I finally got through! What happened just now? What the heck did you do? Anyway, I'm heading your way now. I want to hear everything about what happened. Here we go. Time to explain. I see. So you have Eden Syndrome too. You were devoured by an eater. So Suedo's theory was right. And your connection jump. You can do that because of your current body is... What I mean is, I'm sorry, I should never have left you behind like that. Don't worry about it. You are too kind. Well, I guess that's that. We have yet another reason to investigate Eden Syndrome. Yep, you do. Get my body back that you fucked up your brain! Let's expose the truth of this story, so we can get you, your body back too. What's wrong? Did something. Shit, digital shift! I kinda hope that we don't go rushing in like we did with the last thing. This is... So the phenomenon we're investigating just so happens to occur right where we've wound up? That's too perfect to be a mere coincidence. Jeez, this keeps catching me off guard. Hey, you're coming too, right? Of course. Because we have a clear target now. Okay, let's go. Fuck, we're inside. Oh, lordy. It never ceases to amaze me. The sight of the digital world, where the real and the electronic intersect. This place looks like it always did before, like a dive without an exit. So all we have to do is take out the Bakuman and change everything back to normal. Or, as some people have pointed out in the reviews, the eater. What now? The heck are you saying? It's not like I think Sakura's special or something. Dude, you're totally high school crushing right now. Felt like... No, there wasn't a Digimetal there. Okay. Heavy Metal Fire. I'm hoping Skullmerimon levels up soon. Atomic Blaster. And badabing.com, bitch! Power up with the Revenge Flame and then the Atomic Blaster. Yes! I'm gonna sound so stupid right now, but I can't help but think of this right now. And for the record, I've been saying this a lot lately. Like, a lot. All because of fucking Mini Lad. Yeah. So, just gonna aim for the other one this time. Yas, bitch! Slay them! Slay them! Well, at least everyone's leveling up, like, pretty decently, pretty quickly. Go to the Digilab, thank Lordy Lou. Also, I'm sorry if the mic is a little louder this time. I'm tweaking it out a little bit just to see what works and what doesn't. If you guys like it like this, then please let me know. I really do appreciate feedback from you guys. I just don't know what's working and what's not, if that makes sense? Okay, it's Lalamon, so I'm gonna get Sunflamon, baby. Lalamon, Digimon 2! Sunflamon! Okay. See who else can Digivolve. Now, I already have a Dorugamon. So, this Dorumon is just gonna be, like, either Wasmon or Cyclonemon. And this one's requiring more attack power. So, I'm gonna go with Wasmon. Okay, you can get to Devimon. You're gonna be a Devimon. Probably gonna have you be a Digitamamon. When you're able to, you're gonna be a Mega Seedramon. And Wormmon is not quite there for speed yet. Wait, what does it have to be? 55? And it's at max level. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna Digivolve you into Ice Devimon. And then immediately de-Digivolve you back. So that way you have more levels and you can get more out of it that way. Now, let's see. Do I want you to be a Clockmon or a Starmon? You're already at max. Gotta be Starmon. Let's just keep going through this real quick, guys. Yeah. Who is the next builder or neutral thing? Okay, so I'm gonna change the leader to Sunflamon for this island. And now we're going to Coralmon in Ogremon's place, and we're going to move Ogremon into Shogun Gekkomon's place. Frickin' getting there. I just hope that everything works out. And this is the one with a lot of ABI. So we're gonna keep you where you are. And can any one of my ultimates digivolve yet? No. Well, we're out of here. There's no Digimetal. Fuck. Oh, shit, I almost forgot to give you guys your items back. Researcher. Give you a cam. Actually, yeah, but we're gonna do it that way. But you guys don't even really need cam, I've been using you a lot. So, I'm gonna switch to intelligence items for you, and SP items for you. What about the lot of you? Another intelligence. Another intelligence. I'm gonna go with another intelligence. And you get two, so you're going to get an attack and a defense. Booyah! Here we go, some challenges. A Leomon! That's actually kind of challenging for this. Well done. Boom! One shot kill. Excuse me. Well, that's one down. One to go. Sun for Mon and Tokemon again. Not bad. Not bad at all, dude. Here we go. Okay. There we go. It actually worked out nicely. And next part of the battle, a Repamon. Represent. sorry, but you're about to get one-o'd. I said sorry. A Comet Hammer level 3. Weakest move is Shock, and Comet Hammer takes that by a mile. So, you can take the Comet Hammer. And now we can go on through. Gotta love Cherry Kool-Aid. It's just the two of you again. It's kind of a letdown. I'm expecting a challenge. This is what I get. Shit. Controller almost fell. Shit. My B. That's what happens when your controller's about to fall out of your hands and you go to grab it and then all of a sudden you hit a button that you don't want to hit. Okay, just because this screams boss, I'm gonna save right here, and then we're gonna go in to fight the boss. Ready? Here we go. I know I just said it screams boss, and you're like, where's the boss? It's a little thing called patience, guys. Okay, there's one threat. And there's another. You. Kind of sad that all these guys are doing right now is really just making me slow my progress. I wish that wasn't the only thing they were really doing. Because at this point, that's all they really are doing. Memory up. I am going to need that memory up. Thank you. Let's move. Here we go. Hugo! That was the ghost of the pale boy that we saw earlier. So if the previous pattern holds, that eater must be nearby, right? Huh? I'm just gonna, like, read over the people that are there now. Hey, what are you guys doing? We thought if we followed you, we'd find the exit. I already told you, I don't need a whole crew of tag-alongs following after me. Whoa, what's that? Yes, the eater! Just as I expected, here it comes. What? Shit, it's going for the people! It's making them have Eden Syndrome and a digital shift. Hang on, seriously? What is that thing doing? Eater. Is eating more. Eater, digivolve to... human mode. So it transformed after devouring a person? Fox Rose, keep up your guard up. There's a theory that it's stronger after transforming. Texture blow? Fuck. That is a blow. But not a beach. Sadly. Okay. War Growlmon just needs to attack first off. Yeah. Gonna cause a revenge flame, so no matter what, you have to fight back. And now Skullmerimon can heal. Do I have an all-purpose? I do? Oh, it's from all. Not gonna do that, I'm just gonna use a sprite recovery. There we go. And a machine break. Melt processor. Oh shit, that's a draining move. Heavy metal fire. Another texture blow. To the same dude? Why? Data is converging again. Okay. Go with another sprite recovery. Destruction cannon. This motherfucker's not really lasting long. Arata! Damn it, Arata! Why?
Why are you helping a man?
Power up with a revenge flame. And boom! Yes! Make it progress again. Just glad that the counter's gonna last for a while. Okay. And let's hopefully kill him now. Yes! Thank you, War Growlmon. Aw, yeah.
Yeah, baby, yeah, baby, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's one less eater on the planet. It was really... It really was as strong as theorized, after all. Huh? Wow. So taking out the eater makes everything go back to normal. Same as always. That's a relief.
にしても、あの化け物は倒せたけど、何がこの異形的現象をコントロールしてるのか。結局わからずじまいってのあの病気のことだって。新しい情報をつかめなかったし。あはー。おお、だって。You, what are you doing here? Digital shift. I came when I detected the digital shift.
Were the two of you caught up in it, perchance? I see. Well then, why didn't you say anything? That's not the sort of thing to keep mum about. And there was something new this time around? Yes. Well, it was powerful. So much that the eater could transform after eating something. That is very interesting indeed. That information fits into a new theory I am postulating. A new theory? It seems that Nita changes its form bit by bit to reflect what it incorporates into itself. By incorporating human data, this Eater was able to attain a form that was close to Hikatsu. Could it be that Eaters have come to find more simple digital data unsatisfied? Could it be attempting to incorporate data from humans, which are organic life forms? Human data? What the heck for? I don't know yet. Not for right now. Thank you very much for the valuable information. Hey, wait! Ah, yes, things have been left unsaid. I know you're a big fan of mine. I find you rather agreeable, myself. What a creepy thing to say. No, your outlaw spirit, wanting to stay unencumbered, your rebellious streak, your desire to defy things greater than yourself. So many possibilities are open to you, Mr. Arata. Let us meet again. Very soon, I hope. Sheesh. I couldn't get a word in edgewise, and then he just up and appears. Disappears. There really is something fishy about him. Is he really just interested in research? I'm not so sure. Okay, I've made up my mind. What have you made up your mind on? I'm going to look into things till I know for sure what Suedo and Kamishiro are really all about. Huh? How am I going to look into them? By sneaking into Kamishiro Enterprises, of course. Are you insane? It should be easy, right? As long as we use your connection jump and my hacking expertise. Besides, we've got connections, don't we? Yuko! I need to think of a plan. I'll be in touch. Well, gonna grab the Digimetal here. Nokia said to meet her in Kowloon. If I'm late, she'll probably get mad again. Well, I'm gonna grab the Digimetal. Going to go and see what was just posted on Digiline. There's a short railroad on the island? Does that mean there was a train too? That's probably true. That's a great guess, I'm impressed. Whatever you do, give it all you got. That's how I became a journalist, you see. When did my mom start thinking she wanted to be a journalist? A dream. I wonder. Did I dream? Okay, so we're gonna go to the Digilab, and then I'm gonna head to Eden real quick. But before I actually get to Eden, I'm gonna just be doing stuff here. And by the time I get to Eden, that'll be the next episode, everybody. Hope everyone's enjoying the series. I know I sure am. And one thing for sure that I'm loving about this series is how much fun it is to me. Because this is all like voice acting practice to me, in a way. Like, doing that voice for Arata is really, really a challenge for me. I've never really, like, done, like, that kind of vocal range or anything like that before. So, it's a challenge to me, and I'm enjoying every moment of it. Oh, Lordy. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Okay, you've got 29 ABI, so if I get you to bolt on, you're gonna be swimming in it. And I'll just be trying to get you to Beelzebub. Yeah. But I'm gonna leave this episode here, guys. Thank you all so much for watching this video. If you like the video, hit the like button. Comment in the comment section below your tips, tricks, and all that shit. Subscribe if you're new. Favorite the video if you want, which if you love hearing me say things that are memes and talking to Arata as if he is my senpai, that's a good reason to favorite it. But as always, rock and roll, do some mixins!